Hi Jana, how are you today?
I'm good, how are you?
Good. So today I will just be asking you questions. I'll be asking you to repeat words. I'll say something and ask you. We'll be looking at pictures and we'll be describing it, following directions. Are you ready to begin?
Yes.
Of course. I will start with asking word definitions. So I'm going to tell you a word and use it in a sentence. I will then ask you to define the word. Tell me what that word means. You can define or explain what a word means by telling what kind of thing it is and by telling some things about it. For example, I may say, the word is giraffe, as in, the children said, the giraffe is over there. You can tell me what the word giraffe means by saying, a giraffe is an animal with a long neck and spotted skin that lives in Africa or in a zoo. Now, I will tell you another word and ask you to define it. The word is mustard, as in, mom asks, would you like mustard on your hamburger? Define the word mustard, please.
Mustard is a yellow condiment that you can put on food like hot dogs or hamburgers.
Thank you. Exactly. Mustard is something you put on food to make it taste good. It can be yellow, brown, and you can eat it on hamburgers and other foods. Now, let's try another word. The word is neat, as in, grandma said, you keep your room very neat. Define the word.
It's you're keeping something like organized and tidy, and it's not messy.
Neat means that something is cleaned up and in order or tidy. Now let's do some more. Remember to listen to the words in the sentence I tell you. Then you define the word, or tell me what the word means. The word is alone, as in, the girl said, I want to be alone. Define the word alone.
Alone is being by yourself and not with others. The
word is little, as in, Dad said, there's little left in the box. Define the word little.
It can be either mean like something small or there's not a lot of it.
Thank you. Here are some pictures. I will point to the circle. Now, you point to the picture that I name. Point to the triangle. Point to the X. Point to the circle. Point to the square. Point to the second circle and the third triangle. Go. Point to the fourth black circle. Point to the fourth black circle and the first white circle. Go. Point to the two circles that are to the right of a square, then point to the last square. Go. Point to the big black triangle, the little square. Point to the big black triangle, the little square, and the little white triangle. Go. Point to the last white circle, the little black X, and then to the black circle. Go. Thank you for working so hard. Point to a circle and a square before you point to the X and the triangle. Go. Before you point to the little black X and the big black X, point to the little white circle. Go. Before pointing to the last square, point to the first circle and the first X. Go. Before pointing to the last circle, point to the first triangle and the first square. Before you point to the square on the left side of the circle, point to the triangle and the X. Go. Before you point to the square on the left side of the circle, point to the triangle and the X. Go. Point to the first triangle, the second circle, and the last triangle. Go. Point to the second square after you point to the third circle. Go. Point to the second little square after you point to the last big triangle and the last little triangle. Go. Point to the little white triangle. Point to the little white triangle, then the little circle in the top row, the white square in the last shape in the bottom row. Go.
Thank you for working so hard.
Point to the middle triangle in the top row and in the bottom row. Point to the second circle, the last square, and the last circle. There is a big white circle, point to the X above the black circle. If not, point to the triangle below the square. Go. If there is a big white circle, point to the X above the black circle. If not, point to the triangle below the square. Point to the third circle in the top row, the shape that is bigger than all of the others, and if there is an X in the bottom row, then point to the black triangle. Go. Guys, one more time. Point to the third circle in the top row, the shape that is bigger than all the others, and if there is an X in the bottom row, then point to the black triangle. Point to the third X and the third little X after you point to the first X. Go. Point to the third X and the third little X after you point to the first X. Go. Point to the big square. Point to the big square in the second circle from the right in the top row. But before that, point to the black triangle in all the circles in the bottom row. Go. Thank you for working so hard. Here are some words that can be made into two different sentences. Tall, the boy is. The boy is tall. This sentence tells something. That's one way of doing it. Here's another sentence with the same words. Is the boy tall? This sentence asks something. Now I want you to try. Make two sentences using the words I show you. Saw, the girl, the boy. Use only those words.
The girl saw the boy. The boy saw the girl.
Here are some more words. Now make two sentences with the words with these words. Is on the chair, the kitten.
The kitten is on the chair. Is the kitten on the chair?
Now let's do some more. Now make a different sentence. Each time, you will make two sentences using the words I show you. If you need me to, I can repeat each one once. Both sentences must be logical and make sense. Make a sentence with these words. The teacher assigned homework, didn't.
The teacher didn't assign homework. Didn't the teacher assign homework?
Make two sentences with these words. She bought the job, the car, after.
She bought the car after she got the job. She got the job after she bought the car.
Make a sentence with these words. The runner, the race, to win, going, isn't.
The runner isn't going to win the race. Isn't the runner going to win the race?
Thank you for working so hard there. I make two sentences with these words. The keys, the girl, her pocket, put, didn't, in.
The girl didn't put the keys in her pocket. Didn't the girl put the keys in her pocket?
Here are more words to make two sentences. Cross, we, the street, here, shouldn't.
We shouldn't cross the street here. Shouldn't we cross the street here?
Make a sentence with these words. The lamp, the woman, the table, put, didn't, on. Make two sentences with these words here. The lamp, the woman, the table, put, didn't, on.
The woman didn't put the lamp on the table. Didn't the woman put the lamp on the table?
Thank you. Thank you for reminding me. Let's make a sentence with these words. The girl, the boy, an ice cream cone, buy, didn't.
Did the girl buy the boy an ice cream cone? Did the boy buy the girl an ice cream cone?
Make a sentence with these words. Glue, could, you, with, that, fix.
You could fix that with glue.
Make a different sentence with the words. Remember, the words are glue, could, you, with, that, and fix.
Oh, could you fix that with glue?
Thank you for working so hard. Now make a sentence with these words. The restaurant, the pizza, to, deliver, going, isn't.
The restaurant isn't going to deliver the pizza. Isn't the restaurant going to deliver the pizza?
I'll make a sentence with these words. She ate hot even though was.
She ate it even though it was hot. It was hot. Even though she ate it.
Now, let's do some more. Make a sentence with these words. The student, the manager, an application, send, didn't.
The student did send an application. Oh, did the student send an application? The manager did send the student an application. The student did send the manager an application.
Thank you for working so hard. sentence with these words. It, she kept broken even though was.
She kept it even though it was broken. It was broken even though she kept it.
Remember, the words are it, she kept broken even though was.
Even though it was broken, she kept it.
Thank you. So hard. So make a sentence with these words. No. Didn't you it where put you?
Don't you know where you put it? You don't know where you put it.
Yeah. Okay, another sentence with the words remember, can't, he, it, if, mailed, he.
He can't remember if he mailed it. Can't even remember if you
You're doing good. Well, a couple more left. Let's make more sentences. Two more sentences with the words the nicest, the person, has, who, the most friends, is.
The person who is the nicest has the most friends. The person who has the most friends is the nicest.
Two more sentences with the words he left, he caught, the house, the bus, after.
After he left the house, he caught the bus. After he caught the bus, he left the house.
Remember, the words are he left, he caught, the house, the bus.
He left the house after he caught the bus. After he left the house, he caught the bus. There is a two. After he left the house, he caught the bus. He left the house after he caught, or caught the bus after he left the house.
Thanks for working so hard. Last one, we're almost there. Make two more sentences with the words was clever, the contest, who, the boy won.
The boy who was clever won the contest. The boy who won the contest was clever.
Thank you. Thanks for working so hard. Now, I'm going to read you some problems to figure out. Each problem has two correct answers. Let's do one and see if you can tell me the correct answers. A man is bigger than A, house, B, button, C, spoon, D, plane.
Button, spoon.
Now, listen to this question and the possible answers. Remember, you must tell me the two answers that are correct. Jan saw Pedro. Dwayne saw Francis. Who was seen? Jan, Dwayne, Pedro, Francis.
Pedro and Francis.
Now let's do some more problems. Remember, you can tell me the two correct answers. If you need me to, I can repeat each one once. In the alphabet, G comes between L and Z, after C, before M, between A and E.
After C, before M.
In any month, the 17th comes between the 11th and the 16th, before the 16th, between the 13th and 19th, after the 11th.
Between the 13th and 19th.
The teacher said more people in the class got C's than A's, but most people got B's. There were more C's than A's, more A's than B's, More B's than C's. Six C's.
More C's than A's and more B's than C's.
Dan is taller than Jeff. And Lee is taller than both of them. Dan is taller than Lee, shorter than Lee, the tallest, not the shortest.
Shorter than Lee and not the tallest. Shortest.
Wanda saw Joe, but not Ricardo or Sandy. They saw her, though. Who is seen?
Wanda and Joe.
The dog sat under the table next to the cat. The food was in a dish on the table. The food was?
On the table.
The dog sat under the table next to the cat. The food was in a dish on the table. The food was a next to the dog, above the cat, under the table, on the table.
Above the cat and on the table.
Thank you. Thanks for working so hard. The librarian said, the library has fewer books on history than on science, but it has the most books on art. There are more books on science than art, fewer books on history than art, the most books on science, more books on art than science.
More books on art than science, and fewer books on history than art.
Thank you for working so hard. The pencil was in the box. The box was in the bag next to the locker. The pencil was in the locker, in the bag, next to the locker, beside the box.
The pencil was in the bag next to the locker.
The chart lists the countries in alphabetical order. Norway comes between South Africa and Taiwan, after Turkey, before South Africa, after Italy.
Before South Africa and after Italy.
Jeff said math is first. Jeff said math is first, followed by science and then lunch. Math is after science, before lunch, between science and lunch. First,
and then before lunch.
We're working so hard. Just a couple more. A quarter past three is exactly 3:15, after 3:25, before 3:35, the same as 3:45.
Before 3:35 and exactly 3:15.
Carlos chose Lewis. And Dan was chosen by James. Who was chosen? Carlos, Lewis, James, Dan.
Lewis and James. Dan.
Thank you for working so hard. Marie is first in line with Angie and Ken standing behind her. Louis squeezed between Angie and Ken. Louis is third in line, second in line, after Marie, before Marie.
After Marie. In the second line?
Marie is first in line with Angie and Ken standing behind her. Louis squeezed between Angie and Ken. Louis is third in line, second in line, after Marie, before Marie.
Third in line, after Marie.
Working so hard. If a person lived for exactly a quarter of a century, he is 50 years old, younger than 40 years old, older than 30 years old, at least 20 years old.
50 years old, older than 30 years old?
If a person lived for exactly a quarter of a century, he is 50 years old, younger than 40 years old, older than 30 years old, at least 20 years old.
Younger than 40 years old, at least 20 years old.
Thank you for working so hard. Only three more. You're getting almost there. Joe likes to feed the dog after taking it for a walk. Bill prefers the reverse. When does the dog get fed? Joe feeds the dog and then takes it for a walk. Joe walks the dog and then feeds it. Bill feeds the dog and then takes it for a walk. Bill walks the dog and then feeds it.
Joe feeds the dog and then takes it for a walk. And Bill walks the dog and then takes
it. Joe likes to feed the dog after taking it for a walk. Bill prefers the reverse. When does the dog get fed? Joe feeds the dog and then takes it for a walk. Joe walks the dog and then feeds it. Bill feeds the dog and it takes it for a walk. Bill walks the dog and feeds it.
Joe walks the dog and feeds it. And Joe feeds the dog and walks it.
Samira cooks dinner Monday through Thursday, and Raj washes the dishes. Samira and Raj switch duties the other days of the week. What will Raj do during the week? Cook dinner on Friday, cook dinner on Wednesday, wash dishes on Monday, wash dishes on Saturday.
Cook dinner on Friday and wash dishes on Saturday, Monday.
Which one?
Monday.
Thank you for working so hard. It's the last one. You're almost done. Joe was born in June, AJ in August, and Frank in February. Each year, Joe's birthday comes between Frank's and AJ's birthdays. AJ's birthday comes between Joe's and Frank's birthdays. Frank's birthday comes before Joe's and AJ's birthdays. Joe's birthday comes after Frank's and AJ's birthdays.
Joe's birthday comes. Yeah. AJ's birthday comes between Joe's and Frank's.
Are you one more time? Joe was born in June, AJ in August, and Frank in February. Each year, Joe's birthday comes between Frank's and AJ's birthdays. AJ's birthday comes between Joe's and Frank's birthdays. Frank's birthday comes before Joe's and AJ's birthdays. Joe's birthday comes after Frank and AJ's birthdays.
Joe's birthday comes between Frank's and AJ's. I don't know.
Oh, you were tired. You did great. You did great. Now you will read some stories. After you read each one, I will ask you some questions about them. Here's the first story. It is 2 pages long. Read it to yourself and tell me when you are finished. Now I'm going to ask you some questions about the story. You may look at it to help you answer the questions. Answer the questions as best as you can. What is the story about?
Two friends, Carla and Marcus, who are getting out of school and they put fires up to get the fine jobs for the summer.
Why did Carla and Marcus create a calendar?
So the jobs they accepted, they were reported on the calendar.
And what would they put on the calendar?
Like, who would do what, like, which day they would, like, water their name, and, like, feed or walk a dog or something.
Name three of the jobs Carla and Marcus advertised they could do.
Walk dogs, mow lawns, and water plants.
Why is it unlikely that shoveling snow would be scheduled on the calendar?
Because it was in the summer.
According to the calendar, what's Carla's second job of the month?
Feed and walk the Garcia's dog.
During the week of the 18th, what job must Marcus complete before he babysits the youngest children?
Plant flowers for Mrs. Long.
If a neighbor calls to schedule a job on Saturday, July 10th, who is more likely to take the job and why?
Carla, because Marcus is already moving.
The first sentence describes Carla and Marcus as counting the days. What does that mean in this story? You can refer back to this.
They were having days till school let out for summer.
You've worked so hard. On which day of the week will August begin?
Sunday.
Why were Carly and Marcus so happy?
Because they got a lot of jobs.
Thank you for working so hard. Now, here is another story. It is 2 pages long. Read it to yourself and tell me when you are finished. Now I'm going to ask you some more questions. You may look over the story to help you answer the questions. Answer the questions as best as you can. What is the story about?
About a boy named James, and his teacher assigned a project that they had to present orally, but he's not happy about it.
What did James do after getting out of school?
He turned on his TV and watched TV.
What geological chance was described in this story?
An underground volcano eruption.
What did James hear on the news?
That an underground volcano erupted in the Pacific Ocean.
What did James do after he heard the news about the new island?
He went to find out more information about it.
Where'd he go?
Library.
Where did he get the information needed to complete his presentation?
Several books and internet sites.
What happens to the lava that erupts from an underwater volcano?
It causes smoke and ash.
Why did James think he was ready to present his report?
Because we gathered up a lot of information.
Last one. What grade do you think James will get on his presentation?
An A.
Thank you. That was this section.
I don't know. I hope not.
Now I'm going to ask you to write. You will use this pen and this page. If you make a mistake or error while writing, please cross them out and continue writing. Do not erase. So here is a paragraph about catching the bus. Every morning, Eric waits for the bus at the corner. The next sentence is incomplete. Read the half sentence aloud and write the rest of the sentence so that it is complete and follows the first sentence and makes the story.
Today it was raining, so Eric brought an umbrella while he waited.
write another sentence here that follows the first two sentences to finish the story.
Eric was glad he didn't have to wait in the rain.
Thank you for working so hard. Now, let's do some more. This paragraph is about a school play. Read the first sentence, finish the second sentence, and write four more sentences that follows to make a story.
After several meetings and a lot of discussion with the students, the drama teacher finally announced that the class will produce Peter Pan for the state competition this year. Although it may be difficult to set up Peter Pan fine on the stage, they will get it done. They will use ropes. And they will practice a lot before the competition.
Thank you. All right, you're doing great. There is one more. I'll have you do the same. Read the first sentence, finish the second sentence, and write four more sentences that follow the story.
When an odd-looking flying craft landed in the field off Route 9, traffic backed up for miles. In both directions, the people got to the site. Police were dispatched to direct traffic while state and local aviation investigators flew in the air. On the ground. People were wondering what was happening. The police closed off Route 9. People were stuck in traffic for a long time.
Thank you for working so hard. Would you like to take a break? Here is a picture of people in a library. I will use the word book in a sentence to talk about this picture. The girl is reading a book. Or I could say, a book is on the table. Here is another picture. Now you make a sentence about this picture using the word reading. You must make your sentence about something in a picture, and you must use the word reading. Look at the picture to help you think of what to say.
The family is reading.
Here is another picture. Now you make a sentence about this picture using the word first. You must make your sentence about something in the picture, and you must use the word first. Look at the picture to help you think of what to say.
The boy was first in line for lunch.
Now, I will say some more words and show you some more pictures. I want you to tell me a sentence using each word I say. You must make your sentence about the picture and must use the word I tell you in your sentence. Before.
The boy wanted to eat the candy before the dad bought it.
Because.
The officer directed traffic because there was no stopping.
Instead.
The boy wanted the book about dinosaurs instead of the book about robots.
Until.
The woman could not eye the bike until the store was open.
Although
the boy had broken his T-cell skateboard.
Unless.
The boy could not play baseball unless he finished.
Now I will say two words with each picture. Say a sentence about the picture and use both of these words that I say. You can use the words in any order. If, then.
If the boy doesn't catch the bus, then he will be stuck in the rain.
And because.
The mom and her kids stopped because the man told them to.
Though, even.
Even though the girl wanted the green shirt, her Her mom wanted her to get the purple shirt.
Or and.
The girl. The girl wanted to go to the Lions or get snacks, but her sister, and her sister wanted to sell this.
Or otherwise.
The boys counted their money before they bought the food, otherwise they couldn't get it.
Almost done. Last one. After, until.
After the boys played at the playground, they waited until they got picked up.
I'm going to read some words. Two of the words go together. Listen to the words. Fish, milk, fin, spider. Fish and fin are the two words that go together. Now let's do some more. Remember, two of these words go together. They are related. Listen to words and tell me the two words that go together best. Dark, hot, soft, cold.
No, cold or not.
Now, listen to some more words. Remember, tell me two words that go together best. Wink, smile, sleep, laugh.
What?
Wink, smile, sleep, laugh.
Wink and smile.
Now, I will read some more words. Listen carefully to each set of words and tell me the two words that go together best. North, Celsius, globe, west.
North and west.
Spring, morning, weekend, afternoon.
Morning, afternoon.
Sniff, eyes, see, hand.
Eyes, see.
Dancing, caring, hearing, smelling.
Hearing smooth.
Smooth, wise, rough, heavy.
Smooth and rough.
Affirming, appointing, achieving, accomplishing.
Accomplishing and achieving.
Equal, early, size, alike.
Equal and alike.
Crooked, connected, joined. Crooked, connected, joined. Rotated.
Joined and connected.
You want about halfway done. Quest, quench, search, literal.
Quest and search.
Longitude, volume, attitude, latitude.
Latitude and longitude.
Enthusiastic, envious, effective, eager.
Eager and enthusiast.
Permanent, temporary, faulty, stereo.
Permanent and temporary.
Disagree, persuade, urge, compound.
Urge and persuade.
Occupied, relevant, Complicated, vacant.
Vacant and occupied.
Adventurous, prosperous, reliable, wealthy.
Prosperous and wealthy.
Only a few more. And well, thanks for working. Biography, lecture, memoir, parchment.
Biography and memoir.
Intellectual, essential, gradual, crucial.
Essential and crucial.
Repossess, recycle, renovate, restore.
Restore and renovate.
Three more. Doing well. Thanks for working. Informal, apathy, imitation, caricature. Yes. They are informal, apathy, imitation, caricature.
Imitation and caricature.
Two more. Thanks for working. Arid, parched, tricky, serene. Arid, parched, tricky, serene.
Serene again.
Assimilate, incorporate, retaliate, articulate. Listen carefully to the words. Assimilate, incorporate, retaliate, articulate. Two of the words are related.
Assimilate and incorporate.
Thank you. You're welcome. Thanks for working hard. Now I'm going to ask you to write. You will use this pen and this page. If you make mistakes or errors while writing, please cross them out and continue writing. Do not erase. Here's a paragraph about catching the bus. Every morning, Eric waits for the bus at the corner. The next sentence is incomplete. Read the half sentence aloud and write the rest of the sentence so that it is complete and follows the first sentence and makes a story. If you make an error or misspell a word, cross out the error and continue writing.
Today it was raining, so Eric brought an umbrella with him while he waited for the bus.
Now write another sentence here that follows the first two sentences to finish the story. You could write the words, something like, Eric was glad he didn't have to wait. Now read to me what you wrote.
Eric, you say it was raining, so Eric brought an umbrella with him while he waited for the bus. Eric was glad he didn't have to wait in the rain.
Now let's do some more. This paragraph is about a school play. Read the first sentence, finish the second sentence, and write four more sentences that follow to make a story.
After several meetings and a lot of discussion with the students, the drama teacher finally announced that the class will produce Peter Pan for the state competition this year. Although it may be difficult to let Peter Pan fly on the stage, something difficult. So if you can find them and save, they will have a lot of practice before the competition.
Yes.
I'm going to read you sentences that I would like you to repeat after I say. My sister is in sixth grade.
My sister is in sixth grade.
Does Mrs. Gomez teach reading?
Does Mrs. Gomez teach reading?
The student who won the award at the art show was very excited.
The student who won the award at the art show was very excited.
The class that sells the most tickets to the dance will win a prize.
The class that sells the most tickets to the dance will win a prize.
After the students have finished the book, the teacher asks them to write a report.
After the students finish the book, the teacher asks them to write a report.
If we had gone straight home after the game, we would not have missed our curfew.
If we had gone straight home after the game, we would not have missed our curfew.
When the students finished studying, they decided to get something to eat before going home.
When the students finished studying, they decided to get something to eat before they went home.
Coach gave the trophy to the team that won the track meet on Saturday.
The coach gave the trophy to the team that won the track meet on Saturday.
The students collected and repaired the toys and sold them at the fair.
The students collected and repaired the toys and sold them at the fair.
Before they walked across the stage for graduation, the students lined up in alphabetical order.
Before they walked across the stage for graduation, the students lined up in alphabetical order.
Before the students were dismissed for lunch, they were told by the teacher to turn in their assignments.
Before the students lined up for lunch, the teacher told them to turn in their assignments.
The math teacher sorted, labeled, boxed, and delivered the calculators.
The math teacher sorted, labeled, and boxed the calculators.
In some countries, the minimum age for obtaining a driver's license is 18 years, considerably older than in this country.
In some countries, the minimum age of obtaining a driver's license is 18, which is older than in this country.
Now, we're going to understand spoken paragraphs. Listen carefully to what I'm going to read you. Afterwards, I will ask you some questions about what I read. After 3 months of renovations, Galaxy Movies is reopening this weekend with a total of 16 theaters. The two original theaters have 500 seats each, and the others can each seat 250. If you buy tickets in advance, you can get free popcorn and a free drink to celebrate the reopening. Before the first movie starts, there will be a prize drawing in the lobby for free movie tickets for a year. What was this announcement about?
Reopening. Movie
What do you get if you buy tickets in advance?
A free drink.
Food. What will happen before the first movie starts? Why was Galaxy Movies closed for 3 months? Describe it to
me. Like, redecorating, redoing it.
Why do you think the owners decided to remodel the theater?
To make it bigger.
What two things could happen if you didn't buy your tickets in advance?
You wouldn't get a seat, or I'm going to be able to see that movie.
Okay. Hurricanes. The Atlantic hurricane season is considered to be June 1st to November 30th. These severe storms rotate in a counterclockwise direction around a calm, low-pressure center called the eye and travel westward across the ocean. A hurricane starts at a low-pressure zone, builds into a tropical depression, and then becomes a tropical storm. Hurricanes have wind speeds from 74 miles per hour to greater than 155 miles per hour. Weather forecasters watch a hurricane's progression over time and predicts its path. If a hurricane heads for a populated area, then weather forecasters can warn people to evacuate. Before a hurricane becomes strong enough to be called a tropical storm, how is it described? It's okay, you're doing great. What is an example of a populated area as the term is used in this story? What do you think would happen if weather forecasters did not predict the path of a hurricane?
People wouldn't be alerted in time if you cause more destruction.
Thank you. Thanks for working. Why would a spring vacation not likely be affected by an Atlantic hurricane?
Because hurricane time is in between like fall and summer.
Why would a spring vacation not likely be affected by an Atlantic hurricane? I saw that. When is the busy season for a hurricane forecaster?
Between like November and June or June.
Which one? November and June or June? November.
June.
Okay, next one. Posters for the dance. Thanks, you're working really hard. The dance committee met on Monday with two members absent. Shannon had been sick with the flu since last week and could not attend. The meeting just slipped Billy's mind and he went to a friend's house after school to play ball. At dinner, Billy's father told him that the chairman had called to see why Billy hadn't attended the meeting and to remind him about the posters. After dinner, Billy went to his room and looked at the stack of half-finished posters. He remembered that he and Shannon were responsible for the posters. The two of them were responsible for putting up the posters Tuesday morning. He couldn't figure out what to do, so he said, "Dad, can I talk to you about something?" Why does Billy need his dad's help?
Because he forgot to get the posters ready.
Name two students who missed the committee meeting.
Shannon and...
What did Billy do before dinner? What might happen if Billy's father doesn't help Billy with the posters?
He won't get them up in time.
Thank you. On to the next one. The Delmar is called Cafeteria Scandal. The Delmar High School Sentinel was The Delmar High School Sentinel was nominated for another school news award yesterday. The winning story will be announced after all nominated stories are reviewed by the judges. The Sentinel was nominated for the award for its investigation of school cafeterias. The student journalist uncovered an illegal operation in which the supplier charged full price but only delivered half the meat and produce that was supposed to be delivered. The state school board has issued a statement commending the Sentinel's journalists for sniffing out the truth and wished them and journalists from other schools good luck in the state competition. Why would Delmar High School students think this was an important paragraph to read?
Because the state competition.
You can finish that sentence.
The state competition is important.
When will the winning story be announced? What did the what did the school journalists do?
Sniff out who sniff out information about the state competition.
What two things did the state school board mention in their statement?
Good luck to all those competing in the state competition. And
you're working really hard. What might have happened if the students had not written their story about the cafeteria?
They would not have been able to compete in the competition.
Yes. Thank you for working hard. Okay. Last one. Last paragraph. It's called the job search. Jason really needed to earn some extra money. He had a regular job emptying the trash and sweeping the floors in the building where his dad worked. But that was only twice a week. He got paid to tutor his neighbor's son, who was in summer school, but Mark only needed help occasionally, and Jason didn't get paid very much. Before he started working at his dad's building, Jason had checked the nearby stores and restaurants and knew they were hiring new employees. Jason knew he needed to be creative if he was going to have enough money before school started again. That morning, he saw the newspaper on the table with a big circle around an ad in the help wanted section. Aha, Jason thought. Maybe I won't have to walk to school this year after all. Why would working hard but hardly working be a good title for this paragraph?
Because he's working hard to try to find a job.
Who is Mark?
The kid he tutored.
Before working in his dad's building, what had Jason done about getting a job?
He was looking, for a job and he knew that people were hiring.
Why wasn't Jason satisfied with the tutoring job?
Because it didn't pay that much.
Why do you think the help wanted ad was left on the kitchen table?
I just gonna come up for Jason. I don't know.
Why did someone leave it for Jason?
Because I knew he was looking for a home.
Why is Jason eager to earn money before school starts again?
So he's not to walk to school.
Thank you. Thanks for working so hard. Are you ready for a break?
Yes.